Vinor on behalf of Agro Aviation Private Limited. So I welcome the ma'am of Tripti Bhushan to tell about the important topic of public speaking and positive attitude towards the people, how they have to improve that. So welcome you, ma'am, on behalf of Agro Aviation Private Limited. The session is over to you.
Thank you so much for a very warm welcome.
Thank
so
you.
So I think without wasting our time, we should start now. So the topic for today's session is like public speaking and positive attitude. So myself, Tripti Bhushan. So like moving ahead, I believe in one, the very famous quote which says is, the man who thinks he can. So if we read this quote, the man who thinks he can says that if you actually think that you can do it, you can actually do it. And if you actually think you're not able to do anything, you won't be able to do anything. So now the topic is public speaking and positive attitude. So now these both terms, the concept of public speaking and positive attitude plays a very crucial role in everybody's life and in your professional career as well. So talking about what is positive attitude, we all know that we have been often hearing many times that people say that, you know, one should be very positive towards your studies, towards your goal, towards your family, towards your every attitude and plethora of thoughts. But in general, if we talk about, so we can say that an attitude is an expression of favor or disfavor towards a person, place, or an event. So I think whatever attitude we have, it defines, it actually overthrows the position what we are thinking. So suppose if we are negative, it will always impact our attitude and our work that we are doing. So we should always tend to keep ourselves positive. We should always try to think positive, try to be happy about ourselves. Because if we are not happy, if you're not surrounded by happy people, definitely we will be so much, you know, into pressure, into depression, that will actually stimulate us and it will somewhere lead us to go down. Now, if we talk about what is confidence, I'm just giving you a very brief overview right now through my PPT. Like if we talk about confidence, now what is the role of confidence in public speaking? So confidence and attitude plays a very essential role in public speaking. You know, one needs to be confident in front of his or her audiences to create an everlasting impression. That is very true. We know that sometime, actually, I'll tell you my example. During my law school, it happened that in my prior law classes or initially my first or second year, I was the one very scared, like how to speak, what to speak, how will I do that? I was tend to have these kind of thoughts in my mind. But then somehow I asked the question to myself, Tripti, if you're not going to do right now, you won't be going to do anytime, anywhere. So you should always try to keep asking questions towards yourself. That will actually keep, you know, motivated. So I think confidence plays a very important role, because if you are not having the confidence to stand up and to utter a word or to actually put your point to your views in front of your audiences, you will stand nowhere. So this is the basic thing that you should always learn to, you know, what to speak, how to speak, you know, this is the basic thing. Now, if we talk about what is the difference between confident and overconfident, now there are two words. So we really do not have to overreact or use fake accent to just to show that you're confident. Confidence is something. Hello, can you hear me? Hello,
yes, ma'am. I am just getting
a distorted voice. Can you please switch off the mic of somebody from the participant?
Oh, I'll take it off, ma'am.
Yeah, please just check it up. So now, I think for to being a confident person, you have to use a fake accent to be confident. I think because this spoils the show anyways. You need to have from inner self. It comes from the inside of your heart, from your inner peace and mind. You cannot just dress up in a very good way or use a fake accent or American accent just to show that you are confident. Never build your confidence, but actually it will pull you down. So now if we talk about what are the benefits of public speaking in brief, if I say, like, obviously if you are a good orator, if you are a good, you know, speaker, definitely your communication skills will increase. You know, you'll have greater impact on people and society. You'll have ability to listen. And, you know, you have greater chance of making new friends and meeting new people. You won't be having anxiety. because I know people who are not able to speak up, and though they are a very good orator, they must be, they are very talented, you know, they are very upfront, but then they are hesitant to speak or utter a word in front of public. So, but slowly and steadily, if you learn to speak, if you build up this confidence in public and this positive attitude, I'm sure you won't be facing this anxiety issue. Now, moving ahead, I'll be telling about, basically, actually, it instance, you know, it actually help, you know, to grow your research work as well. So what happens is that if you're a good orator and if you have to research on something and you have to present that, so a presentation skills also is must for your job career or, you know, in your law schools or in your any of the professional facet that you're doing. Actually, the positive attitude actually builds a confidence, you know. The good public speaking give you a sort of, you know, accomplishment, you know, that, okay, fine, I can speak now, this is me. So you have to have this sort of aura in you. I know that people tend to get very nervous at very time, you know, that they think that, okay, I cannot speak. Now what will happen? The audiences will make fun of me. You know, I cannot speak well. I know Hindi. I don't know English. That's okay. That's totally okay if you do not know Hindi or if you do not know English. But my point is that whatever you know, you should be very upfront to be clear and put your points in front of your audiences. Now, you know, to make a successful presentation, you also need to research on your topic thoroughly, like I said that. So now you'll learn where to find the information. You need for each presentation, like how to tell, what to tell to the people. You know, sometimes it happens that people just get very much afraid of actually quoting what they thought. So what happens is that sometimes even you must be facing a lot of issues in your families, in your career perspective, in your life. So people say that, you know, be alone, just, you know, just do not think negative, be positive. So now people keep on saying this word, be positive. So what is actually the word positive means? Positive means the happy facet of life, things to do, whatever you like. You know, you should always do those things that make you happy, that makes you alive. Either it can be writing a book, it can be writing a story, it can be listening to a music, it can be a dance, or it can be a script, or it can be, you know, reading a newspaper even. So do those things that make you, you know, happy from inside, not from outside. We say that this is a facial expression. So that when a person is happy from inside, when a person is positive from inside, it will act automatically implicit on the face of the person itself, right? So you need to be happy from inside. Your inner peace should be happy, not from the outside. So this is the major thing. And if you're positive always, if you always think positively, I'm sure your people around you will be always happy, right? So this is a basic concept about positivity and public speaking. So now these terminology actually corrects, like public speaking and positivity is actually together. It cannot be differentiated. So if you are confident enough to talk to a person, like if you're able to go for the interview, but you're negative, like, okay, I am going for the interview, might be I won't be selected. These thoughts generally come and overdo your mind. It happens with me also. Sometimes when I go for the interview, might be initially I used to think, okay, fine, Tripti, I'm going for the interview. What will happen? Will I be selected or will I be not? I think, will I be able to speak or will I be not? So these are the negative thoughts that make me depressed, that make me insecure. So this is wrong. But on the very next day, when I started thinking, no, Tripti, I can do that. It's just an interview. I have to go. I have to answer the questions, like whatever my interviewer will ask to me. So you need to be resistant. You need to be calm. You need to be polite in what you're doing. You do not have to rush every time, right? One cannot be rushing. So this is the major thing. Now, moving ahead, if I say that understanding the importance of positive attitude, you can see the clear image from my presentation, which talks about that. You can see a happy face. You can see a bold, like you can say a facet or impression or expression. So I think having a positive attitude will help you experience plenty of positive emotions. There are a lot of emotions, you know, emotions of sadness, of happiness, of love, of anger, anxiety, the plethora of emotions. Now, these are the moments when you are not bogged down by negative emotions. A positive attitude can help you find more fulfillment and enjoyment in life. It can also help you recover from negative experiences more quickly. Actually, this is very true. Suppose if I'm not well, it happens. If I'm not well, I'm totally depressed. You know, I have to eat a lot of medicines. That gives me a sense of, you know, discomfort in my mind. You know, I am like, I won't talk to people. I will be staying alone. I won't be interacting much. So this will give me a, you know, a wrong side of me. Might be I'm having a fear. Might be I commit a suicide because I'm not happy. You know, I don't want to talk to anybody. I'm not understanding the emotional zone of my mind. But guess if I am positive, things will be positive. I would find a reason of happiness in every single thing that I do or people around me do. So you need to keep yourself updated. Updated with happiness. You need, because happiness is something that you cannot buy. It is within yourself. You need to realize it up. You need to realize yourself that what actually you owe. There are a lot of qualities which everybody has, but it happens that we do not realize it. We actually fight for everything that, okay, because we actually presume. The presumption actually comes to our mind because we actually know that if we talk about confidence, we think that we are lacking it. You know, we actually lack, but we are not. We need to fight for it. We need to practice. I know some people stammer. It happens that there are many of my friends, they stammer while speaking. And they're very hesitant to go on the stage or, you know, go for a presentation, for a meeting or every time. But that's okay. Everybody has some sort of, you know, lacunas. But that doesn't mean you cannot do this. You cannot improve upon. You can improve upon. Just you need is practice. Just you need is self-control. You need to be resistant about what you're doing. Right. Now, positive attitude leads to creative minds, you know. We are talking about creative minds. So in addition to physical benefit, a positive attitude produces a broad, flexible and cognitive organization in ability to integrate diverse material. You know, these effects are linked to increase in neutral dopamine levels, which improve your attention, creativity and ability to learn. Positive emotions also improve a person's ability to cope up with difficult situations, which means that obviously, that is a very two-faced, like positive attitudes leads to creative mind. If you are positive, you will have a different zone. You will be able to think, you know, positively. You'll be able to think that what you have to do. If you are depressed, if you are negative, you won't be able to figure out what actually you want. You will be very confused with the state of the mind. But if you're happy from inside, you can learn, you can chill, you can think, you can create something new. But when you're sad or depressed, when you don't feel like interacting with anybody, you'll give up at the time. So this one should not be doing it. Right. So now what actually happens, you know, when you're a good orator, when you're a good communicator, first of all, good communication is very important in your career perspective, because when you're able to communicate with the people, your colleagues, your friends, your class fellow, you're able to express what you're feeling. The express of your feeling is very important to be reach out to the person you wanted to share. Sometimes we want to say hello to somebody, but we're not able to speak hello because we are, you know, afraid. What if I say hi to a person? How will he or she react to it? Because we have that mental zone. No, we have that discomfort in mind that we're not able to do. So you need to realize and you need to be upfront. I think public speaking is a very, you know, common phobia that I've seen these days in students, in people and everyone. So, now moving ahead. I'll be sharing my slide then. It's write about positive things in your day, which means that one should always do positive things in your day. Like one should always write what you're feeling. That will give you a satisfaction, give you a happy face it. Right. Which means that if I wanted to do something good in life, I will always write it down. That makes me happy. I will figure out what keeps me happy. What keeps me, you know, in a playful mode. That gives me a positive energy. So I will always try to write it in a copy or a pen. And I will try to figure it out at the end of the day. What gives me satisfaction? It can be different thing for different people. It differs. For me, being a law, like for being in a law profession, I think for me, reading books or writing is something that I enjoy. Might be a person who's a singer, love singing or creating a new song or writing a new script. So everybody has different thought of, you know, mentality, different thought of preferences in life and happiness. Sort of, because everybody has a different zone that keeps them happy. Somebody can love eating food. That gives them happiness. For somebody, shopping is the key for happiness. And for somebody, you know, singing, dancing, talking to friends is a key of happiness, right? So the plethora of happiness is in your mind, right? It's all about, you need to figure it out. Now, this is the end. But now moving ahead, I would like to ask a very, I think it's a very big and important perspective, that is greater social influence. If I talk about benefits of public speaking is greater social influence. It means that whenever you are speaking in a very good way, whenever you are able to communicate with your partner or your person or your family or your colleagues, people will listen to you. People will want to listen to you. But if you're not able to talk, if you're not able to convey what you're feeling, what you have to, nobody will listen to you. This is a disadvantage. So that's why I think public speaking these days is a very must, you know, skill that you should learn. You should practice. One should practice. Nobody should give up. It happens that in thought, in mind, it comes that, okay, I cannot speak now. I cannot learn because I am from a Hindi medium college. It happens when I'm from a Hindi medium school. So I always thought that, no, I cannot do this. I can never learn that. I cannot be, you know, because I have never been to a, you know, English medium school. So I cannot do that. It's okay if you're not studying in an English medium school, but you can practice. You can inculcate that. You can grab that, right? This is what makes you learn. Now, if I talk about enhanced ability to listen, which means that if you're a good orator, if you're a good, you know, influencer or a orator or a speaker, you'll have the ability to listen. People will listen to you. You know, people will listen to you carefully what you're saying. They won't interrupt you. But suppose if you're not able to speak, if you're not able to communicate, might be it happens sometime in the audiences, people won't listen to you because they won't be giving you attention towards it, that what you are saying. So always try to think. And how to improve this? You need to see your body language. You need to put a check on your voice modulation. You need to be very calm, very patient. And you need to speak, you know, in a zone that actually influences the audiences. The quality and the choice of words matter a lot. You cannot speak anything in upfront of your audiences, right? But the confidence, how will you get this confidence? You cannot buy the confidence from the market. Nobody will give you this confidence in the market. You cannot just go and ask that, okay, I want this confidence. Can you just give me? No, you cannot. It's just that you need to learn from the experiences. People commit mistake, right? But then what happened? Slowly and steadily, they grow. They learn what they have done wrong in the past. Right. So one should be very much in the learning mode. If you have this attitude, if you have this negative attitude that, okay, I don't want to learn. I won't be learning this. That's okay. You will never grow. You will never succeed. But if you always have this positive attitude in mind that, okay, I want to learn something. It's okay if I failed once. If I failed in my class 12, doesn't matter. I'll do more good. Because you have this attitude of learning. You have this positive attitude. You don't have this attitude of giving up. What happened during this COVID time? We all are locked down in our home. We are not able to move out. So what actually happens that it gives us a negative thought. People are thinking, students are thinking when the college will be opening, when the university will get back to the normalized schedule of the lectures. So everybody is facing this negative facet of thoughts because they're not able to move out of their place. They're all scared. If we'll move out, might be COVID can, you know, we'll be having a COVID. We should not move out. So this negative thought can lead you into depression because they're not doing anything. They're just thinking negative. So if you are thinking over one thing again and again, that will lead you into trouble. So my suggestion is for everyone is that one should never overthink or one should not overreact. One should try to accept your problem, accept your mistake. One should not be bogged up by the life. That's okay. I know the situation is really bad right now, but one can be positive in every zone, right? You right now you're at home. So you have a lot of options. For students, they have a lot of options how to, you know, like pass on their days. They can actually join some online lectures. They can join some online webinars, online series. They can go for a lot of competitions, right? So this will keep them give them a positive attitude. But for public speaking, again, I can say that person can actually practice in front of the mirror. If you're hesitant in speaking, if you're afraid, like, okay, fine. If like sometime, I think for me, what I've learned during my career or my face it, like since school time to college to university, I think for me, practice is very important. And you know, always I believe if I don't know something, I will be doing that again and again. अगर मुझे कोई चीज नहीं आती है तो मैं वहां पे स्टैग्नेंट नहीं रहती, राइट? अगर मुझे कुछ बोलना नहीं आ रहा, मुझे कुछ चीज नहीं आ रही, आई एम लैकिंग समथिंग, सो आई वोंट बी गिविंग अप. आई विल जस्ट प्रैक्टिस दैट. आई विल 20 टाइम्स स्पीक दैट वर्ड. यू नो समटाइम इट हैपेंस कि आप कोई वर्ड प्रोनाउंस नहीं कर पाते हो, यू एक्चुअली स्पेल रॉन्ग एंड यू थिंक नाउ माई कलीग्स और माई बैचमेट्स विल मेक फन ऑफ मी बिकॉज आई हैव नो कॉन्फिडेंस, आई स्पोक रॉन्ग, लाइक दे विल क्रैक अ जोक. इट्स ओके इफ पीपल आर क्रैकिंग अ जोक, right? But then you want in future, nobody should do that. So you need to practice. You can practice in front of the mirror, you can practice the inner self, you know, you can talk in English, you know, you can try to write whatever you have in your mind. You can just actually pen it down. You can pen it down in your copy or notebook, and then you can ask to yourself. Always ask a question to yourself: am I capable? Yes, I am. Never say that you're not. Because when you are not positive yourself, you cannot be positive and you cannot make other people feel positive about yourself. It happens that when I went to one of the conferences and I saw one of the very young student in class, I think 11th, she stood up and she was speaking on some science. She was giving a presentation on science lecture, something like that. I don't remember. It is like 4 years back. But the moment she started off speaking, she spoke in Hindi for a minute and then she turned on back to English. Everybody was looking at her because she was speaking so gracefully. She was speaking, she was convincing. So the power of convincing depends upon you. It comes from your speaking skills. How you can convince your audiences, how you can convince your public, how you can convince your colleagues, how you can convince your batchmates that what actually you want. So these all things are really much connected, like positive attitude, public speaking. Now, if you talk about greater control over emotion than body language. So for public speaking on the outer stage, body language matters a lot. How you stand, how you talk, what is the posture? You cannot just, like I've seen people speaking in audiences, they shake their hands. They move their legs. So which is gives a wrongful impact. You need to be still. You need to be standing at a place. You need to be firm. Right. You cannot just be fizzy. You cannot just move your hands in public. So there are certain qualities of a good orator that one should know and one should learn. Nobody will teach you. Nobody taught me even. When I was young, when I grew up, when I did my schooling, I also had a little bit of, you know, the sort of nervousness, you know, but then after my college, like when I came to my college, I learned a lot. I learned from my mistakes. So one should learn from their mistakes. Like nobody is less. Everybody has that equal zone. Everybody has this confidence, but you have to realize it that somebody realized it earlier. Somebody realized in their later on. Now increase self-confidence, improved communication skills. You know, lesser anxiety and fear when speaking in front of public. Actually, what is the benefit of public speaking? Now the most is lesser anxiety and fear when speaking in public. What does this mean that? It means that obviously if you're a good orator, you won't have this fear in mind. Ki what people are thinking. Mere baare mein log kya soch rahe hain? Kya sochenge? Kaise react karenge? Whether I'll able to speak, main kya bolungi, koi sunega mujhe? These are the questions or thoughts that actually run to my mind. And it comes to everybody's mind. It is a very common thought. कहीं भी आप जाते हो, कहीं भी कुछ आप बोलने जाते हो, either if you are in a school, in a college, if somebody asks you to give presentation, so you have this in mind. आपके दिमाग में वो चलता है, वो thought, it will run through your mind that okay, how will I do this? I think I won't be able to do this. You're very nervous. You ask a lot of questions to yourself. So I think ये पूछने से अच्छा है कि आप ये सोचो, no, I can do that. It's my first time. I know that, but I can do it. थोड़ा डर लगेगा इनिशियली, यू विल बी फीलिंग, यू नो, यू विल फील सम डिस्कम्फर्ट बिकॉज पीपल हैव द स्टेज फियर. सो स्टेज फियर खत्म तभी होगा जब आप स्टेज पे जाओगे, Right. When you go in public, then only you can actually lessen your fear. Your anxiety will be less. But if you won't be doing that, it would never, you know, overcome. So try to overcome your fear. That's okay. That's okay if you're not able to hold up for 1 hour. It's okay to speak for 5 minutes. But wo 5 minutes mein jo aapne bola, that should have a lasting impact on the public. Doesn't matter you spoke for 1 hour. It happens. Kabhi kabhi log ek ghanta bolte hain, but they did not leave a lasting impact on the audiences. But people who spoke for 5 minutes, they have much more impact on the public. So your mind, your positive attitude works for you. It actually works for you. If you're mentally strong, if you're mentally stable, you are always positive. You're happy in what you're doing. Like, it will actually make people around you happy. Right. And when you see this happy faces, happy zones, this will give you enlightenment. Right. Because if always you're negative about yourself, your thoughts, you won't be excelling in your career. Because you have this one point in your mind that I cannot do it. I cannot crack exam. You know, I cannot crack UGC NET. I cannot crack my judiciary paper. I cannot be an IAS officer. Why I can't be? Because I don't know how to speak. I don't know what will happen. You know, I think nahi ho payega. I cannot do it. So these are the negative thoughts that run to your mind. Right. And that actually makes you down. This actually gives you a discouragement. So you should not think about it. You should think about what you can do. Do not wait for the results. If you will excel, results will be in your favor. So try to think in a positive way. Ask yourself, I have my paper. I can do that. I can crack that. I can give that. You know, yes, I can crack that. It's okay. I can be an IAS officer. I can crack UGC NET. That's very, very often. But never put your mind in trouble. Never pressurize your mind. It happens that you come in influence of your like colleagues or your friends, and then you tend to get negative. Sometimes it happens. Even in your family, you must find that people come to your family or they give you a lot of, you know, talks. They could say that tumse nahi ho payega. You cannot do this. So you just not be, you know, taking that thing too much. Usko bahut zyada apne mind pe haavi mat hone do, you know. You cannot just pull those things over your mind. Be calm. Be composed. Because these are the two things that can lead you a happy life. Agar aap positive ho, apni cheezo ko loke, apne life ko leke, to life mein kuch bhi ho jaye. You cannot never get down. You'll always excel. And public speaking, agar aap achha bolte ho, theek hai, achha matlab, I'm not asking about like superb or you have to have that American accent. No. Public speaking ka matlab ye nahi hota ki aapne, you know, 2-3 fancy words bol the audiences, man, you're okay about that. You can speak. No. Public speaking means that ki aisi bhasha jo aapke samne wale audiences ko convince kar paye. Jo aap feel kar rahe ho, jo aap soch rahe ho, what you're thinking, you're able to, you know, send that thoughts or message to the person listening to you. Agar aap apni baat keh nahi pa rahe ho public mein, there's no point of standing there. You cannot stand like mom. You cannot be a statue. Right. So there's no point of public speaking when you cannot even utter a word. So you need to convince yourself. You need to be happy about yourself. You need to build confidence in yourself that you can do that. Yes, I can do it. I can do this. I will do this. I have to do this. So these are the questions that should always run to your mind. It actually works. It actually worked for me. There was a phase in my life that actually, during my like last year of my college, I felt very, discouraged that, okay, I think I was not well. And it gave me a lot of negative thoughts that, Tripti, I think you're going to fail this semester because you're not well and nahi kar paoge. You cannot do this. You cannot crack your final exams and you'll give a back paper. So there are a lot of negative thoughts in boosting my mind. But then what I thought was that I just took a pen. I just sat for 5 minutes in silence, in a peaceful zone. And then I wrote few questions asking myself, because I think time is the most important thing that you should realize. Samay dobara nahi aata. So one should learn to value time, you know, and what you actually have. So I just wrote one line in that paper ki If not today, then when, Tripti? If not today, then when? Because college won't be waiting for me for next 5 years to give my final year paper. Nobody will wait for me. You know, I'll get well and again, my 5 years baad aake paper do and then I can give and clear the exam. No. So if not today, then when? So nothing has an end. Nothing has an end. It's just that you need to start from somewhere. You should know the starting point of your life. If you are able to realize this, you will able to do a lot in life. If you don't know the starting point of your life, you don't know from where to start, how to start, you will just be troubled. Now, I have mentioned this role of confidence in public speaking. So, there's a line like one needs to be confident in front of his or her audiences to create an everlasting impression. Yes, of course, you can create an everlasting impression. If you are a good orator, if you are able to convince, if you have the power, if the power, whether you're speaking wrong, doesn't matter, but you're able to convince your audiences, that's all. You can 1 million of hearts. But you just need to be that stagnant. You need to be positive. You need to learn. You need to practice. You need to have self-faith. You need to trust yourself. Nobody will trust you until and unless you have the trust. You have the ability to learn, ability of confidence, ability to speak in public. So, sabse pehli baat hai, trust bahut zaruri hai khud pe. For anything, you need to trust yourself. You need to have faith in yourself. Because if you won't be having faith in yourself, nobody else will be, you know, having faith in yourself. People will take you. They'll take you for granted. So you need to be very calm, composed, and positive, and have faith in yourself. Now, positive attitude ki humne baat ki thi. So attitude can be negative also, can be positive also. So now your attitude is based on your current emotional status. So everybody has his zone of mind. Sabke dimag mein kuch na kuch chalta hai. What is this emotion? Emotions are the hard and fast, you know, part of a life. Sometimes you're very happy. Sometimes we are very sad. Sometimes we are very angry. We are very agitated because we are fighting with our own emotions. We do not know that what is coming to our mind. Kabhi-kabhi aisa hota hai, bahut si chhoti-chhoti baaton pe hum gussa ho jate hain. Kabhi-kabhi hume pyar aata hai. Kabhi-kabhi hume kisi pe bahut anger, bahut nafrat. You know, bahut sare different emotions hain jo hum face karte hain. But hum usse vyakt nahi kar paate. We are not able to express that. So this is where we are lacking. So we try to find out ki actually what sort of emotions we are having. You need to think, you need to be calm. And in all those things, you need to pick up one emotion that is positive. Because sometimes what happens, people will, you know, always into influence of people or might be in their depression or their disagreement or this facet. They actually be very, you know, depressed, you know, very sad. You know, so they actually pick point only one emotion of anger. Emotion of sadness, you know, emotion of disgraceful, but that's wrong. You need to figure out the positive attitude, you know. So this will large, like lasting impact. You need to have self-control on the emotions. Because if you are not able to control your emotions, you will be facing trouble in life. So this is the basic thing, how a positive attitude can change your life. There are people, you know, there are disabled people in life. I always, I believe in reading interviews. I keep on seeing people, students in my college too. They are disabled. They're not able to walk. We can even walk. We have two hands to write. We have two legs to walk. But then still, we feel very negative about ourselves. Ki hum ye nahi kar payenge, hum wo nahi kar payenge. We cannot crack exam. We are very negative. But then I have seen those little disabled child who are sitting on the wheelchair, but they're so positive. How? They can also be negative about themselves because they have greater reason to be negative because God has taken all those, you know, beautiful hands. They cannot write. They are paralyzed. But no. Agar woh aaj ye soch le ki hamare paas haath nahi hai likhne ko, hamare paas legs nahi hai, hamare paas pair nahi hai, hum toh kuch nahi kar sakte. We are useless on this earth. They will actually lose their mind. It is a traumatizing facet. So, हमें ये differentiate करना सीखना होगा that what we are having, We need to be happy from that. We need to find out a reason of happiness, the things which we have or which we like. Happiness doesn't mean that. You cannot just copy happiness. Suppose if somebody like watching a TV, so it cannot be a happy thing for you because sometimes you like reading. So you have different things for your happiness. You cannot just copy happiness. Like agar kisi ko likhna pasand hai, to zaruri nahi ki aapko bhi likhna pasand hoga. So you have different zones. You have different choices and different priorities in life. So one should know ki aapko kya pasand hai. Aap free time mein kya karna chahte ho. So you need to figure out those things. Write it down. Write it down your choices that makes you happy. Write it down your career goals that you want to achieve in life. And then figure out how you can do that. You need to set a goal in life. You need to reach to that goal. And without a positive attitude, one won't be able to reach to that goal. Because goal banane ke pehle hi aap agar discouraged ho jaoge, if you want to travel to London, but you're like, I cannot afford the ticket of the flight. I think I cannot go to London. So this is a negative thought. But then if you say, yes, I wish to visit London. I wish to go to London. But then I think I can work hard to buy the tickets, you know, tickets of flight, 2 days ticket for flight from London. Yes, I can go. So you need to find out the reason that how to achieve, how to improve yourself, how to sustain. These all things matter a lot. Right. So this way gives you the positive energy. And if you are positive, you will keep others happy. And you won't be depressed. Sometimes this depression is very serious. It actually gives a very, you know, wrong impact on society and even your friends and your family. People can commit suicide. It happens. During COVID, it is happening a lot. I've seen people sitting idle. They're very much depressed. I cannot do this. I think there's no life. They keep on, you know, talking negatively to themselves. So this is wrong. But you should be very positive. You should talk positively to yourself, right? So this is what matters. Now, this line, the man who thinks he can, what does actually this mean? The man who thinks he can means, jo sochta hai, wo kar sakta hai, right? Agar aap sochoge nahi, nahi kar paoge. But there's a different in thinking. There is two way of thinking, a positive and a negative side. The mentality differs, right? So you need to choose ki aapko sochna kya hai. What do you have to think? You have to think positive. You do not have to go into deeper zone of negativity because that will hassle. Aapko, you know, kuwe mein nahi kudna hai. Aapko dhoondna hai khushi. You know, you need to find out the happiness. You're right. So agar aap sochoge, I can, I will, then you can. But if you think, if you talk, I cannot, I won't, you won't. You never won't. So, ye attitude aapko change karna padega. Aapko attitude aap khud se karoge. Koi aur nahi karega. Koi dusra insaan aapko bata sakta hai. One can guide you. I can only tell you that you need to plan this. You need to be positive. But then, you have to realize yourself. Nobody can spoon feed you. Right. So, the importance of public speaking, positive attitude has a greater role in life. It will make you excel in the career. And if you don't have this attitude of positivity, I'm sure people will have various issues in even in their job perspective, in their careers, in their college, in their, you know, schools. Because they don't know to control. They don't know how to control their emotion. They don't know how to convince. They don't know how to talk, how to speak. So they will face a problem. So the better option is that practice, learn, have confidence, you know. Confidence is a thing, it is within yourself. You need to stand up. You need to realize. You need to talk to yourself. You don't need anybody to talk to. You can talk to yourself. Sit in the ideal room. Right. Figure out. Talk to yourself. Ask questions to yourself and answer. So until and unless you won't be answering, you will be mum. You won't be letting out your thoughts move out. Your thoughts will, you know, grab you. It will just actually hold on to you. वो आपको बंद कर लेंगे. आपके negative thoughts आप पे इतने भारी हो जाएंगे कि आप positivity देख ही नहीं पाओगे. So that's why we are actually, you know, we actually tell people that कि जो भी आपकी negative thoughts उसको, you know, मत सोचो, उसको मत निकालो. Don't overreact on certain things. don't overthink too much. You know, be calm, be light. Kam socho, but achha socho. Right. This is what we believe. This is I believe, you know. Ki always have this in mind that you are actually the same. But then if you want to be different, if you want to stand out in public, if you have to make your own identity, you know, in career, so you need to have good, you know, skill, good public speaking skill, because these are the basic soft skills, you know. So agar aapko yehi nahi aayega, so nobody will listen to you. Nobody will listen, give a chance to you. Bhale aapke paas knowledge bahut hai, but agar aap us knowledge ko you're not able to send this, you're not able to express your knowledge, you're not able to communicate with your students, that knowledge is of its waste. It's no point. Kyunki, suppose I'll give you a very simple example. It happens kabhi kabhi aap, you know, abhi kabhi jaise aapko, if you're not well, you are feeling hungry, or you might be dissatisfied by something. So you know this zone of dissatisfaction, aapko pata hai ki that you're very angry, aapko gussa aa raha hai. But agar aap express nahi kar pa rahe ho, ya aapko bhook lagi hai, if you're not able to tell this to your mom that you're hungry, so how will she know that? She won't be able to know that you're feeling hungry. So you need to express. You need to express your gratitude, your positive thoughts in front of everybody. You need to learn. You need to speak. Agar aapke paas bahut sari knowledge hai, aap chahte ho bolna, but aap darte ho ki nahi bolunga, kya bolunga, kaise bolunga. Agar kuch galat bol diya to, log kya kahenge? You know, these are the thoughts. What people will think of me? I do not know this. So, these all questions bahut aaye the. Mere ko bhi aaye the. My friends, like I've seen everybody has. It's a very common zone. We all feel the same. But then we need to work on this. We cannot sit with this thought every time. I cannot do this. I don't know how to speak, how to talk, how to convince. No, it's okay if you don't know. One can work on this. One can be resistant about it. So, you need to learn. You need to learn the zone of happiness and be positive about it. So yes, this is all about, I think I'm able to convince, this is all about the basic how to be, you know, confident, how to build up this positive attitude and how to speak, how to learn. So practice, you know, is very important. It's a key towards success. And to know what makes you happy, right? You need to be positive. Positive about everything, what you think, what you do, how you do, this all matters a lot. So I think this is all for the session today. Am I audible? Shikhar, hello?
Yes, you are very much audible.
Yeah. So I think this is all for the session. If anybody has anything to ask on, so...
You can even type in the chat box.
Okay, I can just...
Not you, like if any audience having any question, they can type in the chat box.
I'm not able to see the chat box, I think.
So anyone, any question?
I think they don't have it right now. So one should...
No, sir.
Okay.
Fine, Raja, over to you.
Okay, so we would like to propose a hearty vote of thanks to you, Tripti Bhushan, for gracing today's webinar and delivering the important topic on public speaking and positive attitude. I'm sure that all the participants have taken note of your suggestion and will initiate that further in their career. Lastly, we thank you again on the behalf of whole Arco Aviation Private Limited team. Thank you so much, ma'am. This was an amazing session.
Thank you so much for welcoming me. Thank you for giving me this chance to grace people. So yes, I had a wonderful session and wonderful day. So thank you so much for inviting me for today's webinar. Thank you.